You know that God is the author of marriage. Marriage was God's idea. The Bible tells us that marriage should be held in very high honor. It's a sacred, godly thing that you do today. See, from the moment God created man, he said, it's not good. It's not good. For man to be alone. I'll make a helper just right for him. See, marriage was God's idea. And from the beginning, he said, I'm going to create a helper for every man. Perfect match. The Bible teaches us you got to wait for the right one. God's choice. See, Solomon said this. Do not awaken love until the time is right. There's a right time. In Genesis, when God said that it's not good to be alone, he said, I'm going to make a helper. And he put the man to sleep. He went into a deep sleep. Joe, we wonder if you're ever going to wake up. This guy went into the deepest spiritual sleep. While he was waiting for that perfect one, he did a lot of sleepwalking. You know, he'd walk around our church and check out the girls. Then he started to sleepwalk down to the Slavic church. See, Joe lived with me. He'd come home from work. And I hear the shower going. And then I would smell the cologne. On the third floor. And I knew he was going out sleepwalking. Looking for that one. It was amazing. Glad, I'll tell you. My son, Michael, there was a lot of campaigns, you know, to grow the church. But I think Joe brought more young women into the church. While he was sleepwalking. But what God did was he took a rib out of the man. From that he formed this new creation called the woman. Here's what the Bible says about you. He's been looking for you his whole life. It says in Proverbs, a man's greatest treasure is his wife. You're a gift from God. You are very special. And
all the while he was sleepwalking.
He
didn't realize he was looking for you. But when he saw you, God brought you from around the world.
Utica, New York.
For this guy.
He
would have still been sleepwalking in his 50s. So you've been given a great treasure. Are you awake? This guy thinks about everything. You got a treasure. The Bible teaches us that Christian marriage is designed to be the deepest, most intimate relationship
you'll ever
experience. When Adam saw the woman, he said, bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. In other words, the deepest intimacy. There's no other relationship
that
should bring you the fulfillment. The happiness and the contentment. Like marriage. That's why when you said bone of my bone. So because of this, a man shall leave his father and mother. God puts the marriage relationship above every other relationship. Marriage is to take precedence. Over every other relationship. Because you have both left your parents.
To now form a brand new family.
The key to this going forward
is
to always keep Jesus and His Word at the center of your relationship. I want to read you one last verse. Colossians chapter
3.
Joel,
I
Esther. You're chosen by God for this new life of love. Paul said, dress in the wardrobe God picked out for you. Compassion. Kindness. Humility. Quiet strength. And discipline. Be tolerant of one another. And forgive one another. And to all these qualities, add love, which binds all things together in perfect unity. May the peace of Christ guide you
in
all the decisions you make. This is a lifetime covenant. Covenants are done for people. So all of your family,
and your friends,
This pledge that we will be faithful. We will stand together
for
our entire lives. We do that before God. Someone said this, the ever-living Christ is here to bless you. The nearer you keep him, the nearer you will be to one another. All right, are you ready? All right, look at your wife. I ask of you, Joe, will you take this woman to be your wife? Will you do everything in your power to make your love for her a growing part of your being? Will you continue to strengthen her from day to day from the best resources of your life? Will you stand by her in health and sickness, in plenty or want, in success or failure, in duty and service at home or abroad, according to the Word of God?
I do.
I ask of you, Esther, will you take this man? You know, he said, one of the things that in the vows, you got to vow to dress him like a man. When you pick out his clothes, it is on my mind, and he's worried about the clothes you're going to pick out. So, I ask of you, Esther, will you take this man to be your husband? Will you do everything in your power to make your love for him a growing part of your being? Will you continue to strengthen him from day to day from the best resources of your life? Will you stand by him in health and sickness, in plenty or want, in success or failure, in duty and service at home or abroad, according to the Word of God? Now let's just say this to one another. Say this to me. I choose you alone.
I choose you alone.
From all the world.
From all the world.
Love in the church.
Love in the church.
Throughout all the changes of life.
Throughout all the changes of life.
I dedicate myself
to you. To you.
And to your life's work.
And to your life's work.
To join with you.
To join with you.
So that together.
So that together.
We may serve God.
We may serve God.
And others.
And others.
As long as we live.
As long as we live.
Lord, be my strength.
Lord, be my strength.
I choose you alone. From all the world.
From all the world.
To love in the church.
Love,
throughout all the changes of life.
I
dedicate myself
to
you
and
to your life's work.
To
join with you.
So that together
we may serve God
and others
as long as we live. Lord, be my strength. Alright, if I could have the rings.